Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. So not only am I a big watch guy, but I'm also a big Star Wars guy. So for my birthday this year, I was gifted a Star Wars inspired watch, combining my two hobbies. I haven't had a good opportunity to review the watch and take a look at it in detail. I guess until now, since the Mandalorian series is, or I guess the season 2 is coming to a close, I figured now would be the perfect time to take a look at this watch in greater detail. So here it is. This is the Boba Fett Unit watch by Nixon. Now I'm just going to start off by saying that this is not going to be your daily beater or anything like that. This is going to be for the person that's very interested in Boba Fett or in Star Wars, and the details on this watch is pretty cool. So I'm just going to preface this by saying that. Let's go ahead and get into the case itself here. So on the diameter is a 44 millimeter, a lug to lug of 57.6 millimeter. We have a lug width of 24 millimeter and a thickness of 15.3 millimeters. So it is a very thick, very chunky watch. This watch is a polycarbonate case, and it's actually relatively light. It only comes in at 70 grams. So even though it is a big hulking watch, it doesn't feel like that on the wrist. It's very lightweight. On the crystal, it comes with a flat piece of mineral crystal, and it does offer 100 meters of water resistance. So that's a good thing. It does have just your standard Chinese quartz movement for this type of watch. So it is like a designer style watch, but the bezel is made out of an anodized aluminum, and it is fixed, so it's not going to rotate at all. So getting into the watch dial itself, we do have a Nixon logo at the top there in yellow. And as you can see, it is a negative display, which it can be kind of hard to read. On camera it is, but in person it's not actually that hard to read. So on the top line, you have the day and date there. So Tuesday, December 15th, and then we have the time on this side, and down there you can see it says PM right there. And then we have a running seconds hand with this little cool, just a 5 second ticker here. You're going to see it changes speed whenever we get into the stopwatch function, but that's just a cool little display just to, you know, keep the screen from looking too dead. And then right here is pretty cool. You're going to see a temperature gauge. Now, I'm not sure where it's getting the reading from. I don't know if it's the case back, but there it is right there. If we turn the watch to the side at the 3 o'clock, you're going to see the Nixon logo here with these nice pushers. They're plastic, but they have like a waffle texture to them. And you're going to see we have drilled lug holes. Now, you're not going to be changing out the strap on this a lot, I wouldn't think. But it does come with drilled lug holes. And on the other side, you do see the Mandalorian logo. I believe that's a Mythosar, if I'm not mistaken. I'm pretty sure Lucas and Dustin will correct me if I'm wrong. But that's pretty cool. A nice little nod to the Mandalorian there. Not the Mandalorian, excuse me, Boba Fett. So that's pretty cool. Same waffle texture on these. So with this digital display, we do have a second time zone. So you're going to press the top pusher here, and it's actually going to switch to T2, which is your second time zone. So technically, this is a GMT, but press that again, and we're going back to the main screen. The top left pusher is going to be your backlight. So I don't know if you could really see that all that well with these studio lights. There it is. And this button right here is going to change your function, I believe. Let's see. So right here we have the alarm. Right here we have the stopwatch. And if you want to watch this running seconds timer down here, you're going to see how fast it moves here. So it's just a cool little visual to say that it is running. Okay, and here's the timer function. So we press the right timer, it's gonna start counting down. There's that. And I believe that's it. So if you ever wanted to adjust anything on this watch, for example, to reset this, you're just gonna push that pusher, or even to change the time here, what you want. Now you've set it for 4 hours and 5 seconds. So that's pretty much the functionality of the watch. So one thing about this temperature gauge right here, I was reading in the manual that you want to actually remove it from your wrist and let it sit in the ambient air away from sunlight for 20 minutes to get the most accurate reading. This has gone up about 5-6 degrees since I've been handling it. So that is one thing. If you want an accurate reading, you want to take it off the wrist and let it sit down on a table somewhere if you're interested in the temperature or anything like that. All right, let's go ahead and take a look at the case back of the watch here. And you're going to see Boba Fett's helmet and the phrase, "as you wish," which is a really cool line that he said. I guess he doesn't really speak all that much in the original trilogy. It's just the mystique of Boba Fett is what made him so popular. So you have the, what does that say up top? The Unit LTD. That's the name of the watch. Then you have Star Wars there. And then down here, you're going to see where it says 100 meters of water resistant and then polycarbonate. And I believe made in China. It is screwed in case back. So it's not screwed down or anything like that. Right here we have, I guess the locking looper is patented. So this is the Nixon logo, and there's the US patent if you ever want to take a look at it. And it's coming on down here. So the strap is very soft and very supple. I was actually surprised on how nice that actually felt on the wrist. On the other strap, you're going to see a Han Solo frozen in carbonite, which just that alone is so cool. Just to say, no one's going to see it on your wrist. You know, it's not going to be shown off. You're going to have to take it off your wrist and show somebody, hey, look at this. This is a pretty cool feature. Or not feature, but this is a pretty cool design that the, you know, person that made this watch wanted to go with. So that is very cool. The buckle is signed, and it says Nixon. I believe it's like a plastic. So, and then I'm not sure if these screws actually do anything. I doubt it, but I guess that's how you would take it off. All right, so let me go ahead and put this on the wrist just to show you what it looks like. I am wearing my Ionos Avisos. I just can't take this off. It's just so cool. I can't do it. I can't take it off. And here it is on my 7.5-inch wrist. Now, like I said, this is a chunker. So, I mean, it's taking up all my wrist real estate. So that's pretty much it. That's going to be the largest size watch I can wear. You can see these horizontal ridges here. And it fits in with the buckle really nice. And even here, it actually, this cutout goes into the Nixon logo. It's a very secured rubber strap. It doesn't feel like it's going to fall off. And like I said, with it being only 70 grams, it doesn't feel that heavy on the wrist. This is just something that you're going to want to wear whenever you go to, you know, you just want to nerd out, I guess. You want to geek out and you want to say, hey, look, I've got a watch just inspired by Boba Fett. Someone's going to come up to you and say, oh, look, your watch looks like Boba Fett would wear that watch. So, yeah, that's the review. Sorry about my voice here. I'm trying a new mic setup and everything like that, and I do have the cove, so I might sound a little nasally. But that's the video. That's the review on this watch. You know, I couldn't recommend this watch to everybody, but if you're into Boba Fett and you're into Star Wars, you're not going to be disappointed. Super cool, and even if you don't wear it all that much, you can still have fun looking at all the stuff on it and looking at all the artwork behind it. So that's the review. Go ahead and leave me a like, thumbs up, and I'll catch you guys on the next one.